Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shankar De and today I will show you instruments in obstetrics and gynecology. In my previous video, I have told you what are the uses of gynecological and obstetric instruments. In this video, I will show you one by one the instruments in obstetrics and gynecology. So see the instrument. This is our first instrument. This is Sims double bladed posterior vaginal speculum. This is double bladed. See, this is one blade, this is another blade. So this is Sims double bladed posterior vaginal speculum. So this is first instrument. Second instrument, see, this instrument is Cascos bivalve self retaining vaginal speculum. This is two valve, bivalve, self-retaining. You can adjust the speculum by the screw, and this is self-retaining variety. So this is Cascos bivalve self-retaining vaginal speculum. So this is second, and this is the third instrument. This is anterior vaginal wall retractor. So this is anterior vaginal wall retractor. See this instrument carefully, anterior vaginal wall retractor. And see, this instrument is uterine turret. See the difference between these two instruments. This is anterior vaginal wall retractor and this is uterine turret. See the end part, terminal part of anterior vaginal wall retractor and uterine turret. See the difference. So anterior vaginal wall retractor is larger in size and turret is slightly slender with sometimes one end blunt, one end sharp and sometimes sharp end at both ends. So this is anterior vaginal wall retractor and this is uterine turret. It may look similar, but you have to differentiate it. So this is anterior vaginal wall retractor and this is uterine turret. Next instrument is this is multiple tooth falcellum. So see the terminal end of this instrument. This is serrated. So this is serrated and gap is present between two blades. So this is multiple tooth falcellum. This is multiple tooth falcellum and see this instrument. This is single tooth falcellum. See, only one tooth is present. That is why it is called single tooth falcellum. Here presence of catch. This is catch, this is joint and these are the plates with single tooth. This is single tooth falcellum and this is multiple tooth falcellum. See, multiple tooth present here. So multiple tooth falcellum, single tooth and multiple tooth falcellum. Next, this is sponge holding forceps. This instrument is sponge holding forceps. See the terminal end. This is sponge holding forceps with fenestration at the terminal end and here is present, catch is present. So it may look similar to ovum forceps. See this instrument. What are the difference between these two instruments? This is sponge holding forceps and this is ovum forceps. In case of ovum forceps, this catch is absent. So here there is presence of catch. This is sponge holding forceps and this is ovum forceps. Sponge holding forceps is almost straight with catch and ovum forceps is slightly curved. See the presence of curve in the blade and there is no catch. And here in case of ovum forceps, the blade is also fenestrated in the terminal part. So you have to differentiate it by two main points. One is by presence or absence of catch, another is curvature of the blade. So this is ovum forceps and this is sponge holding forceps. Next, this is Alice forceps. This is Alice forceps. So Alice forceps, you can see here also presence of gap in between two blades and terminal part seems serrated with presence of
teeth. What is the difference between this instrument and this instrument? Alice horses and Valsella multiple tooth. See the size. Usually this is longer than usual Alice tissue horse, and usually carved variety is mostly available in case of multiple tooth Valsella. But Alice tissue horse, the blades are straight with terminal serrated end. This is Alice horse, used to hold the rough structures. This is Alice horse. This is another Alice horse, slightly longer. So these two instruments are Alice horse. See the terminal end carefully. So these two instruments are Alice forceps. Alice forceps. Next, this is Babcock forceps. This is Babcock's tissue forceps. See the terminal end with fenestration with gap in between two terminal end, two parts, and there is presence of fenestra, and also the end is serrated. See, one end is grooved, another end is sharp. So this is Babcock's tissue forceps. You have to identify this forceps after seeing this end. So this is Babcock's tissue forceps. This is artery forceps. This is artery forceps, straight variety. See the presence of transverse striation in the blade. So this is artery forceps. So this is artery forceps, and this is also another artery forceps, small variety, mosquito forceps. So artery forceps and artery or hemostatic forceps. This is small variety, mosquito forceps. See, this is the needle holder. What is the difference between artery forceps and needle holder in structure? See, there is presence of groove in inner part of the blade. So this is needle holder, to hold the needle tightly. So there is transverse striation along with presence of groove. So this is artery forceps, a needle holder, and this is artery forceps. This is artery forceps and this is needle holder. Next, this is Cocker's forceps. This is Cocker's forceps, Cocker's artery forceps. See presence of sharp teeth in one blade, another blade is grooved. See, there is groove to accommodate the another sharp part. So these two parts are complementary to each other. One blade is sharp teeth, presence of one sharp teeth, and in another blade there is presence of groove. So this is Cocker's artery forceps. This is Cocker's artery forceps. This is another Cocker's artery forceps. See the presence of groove and presence of teeth as a one blade. So this is Cocker's artery forceps. See, this instrument is teeth cutting forceps. See this instrument carefully. This is teeth cutting forceps. Used to cut the stitches. So this is teeth cutting forceps. See, this is our next instrument. This is plain scissor. And what is this instrument? This is episiotomy scissor. So what is the difference between these two instruments? See, both the blades are sharp in case of plain scissor. But in case of episiotomy scissor, one is sharp and another is blunt. So this is episiotomy scissor. See, one end is pointed and another end is blunt. So this is episiotomy scissor and this is plain scissor. So this is plain scissor and this is episiotomy scissors. This is our next instrument. I have already shown you this instrument. This is ovum forceps. There is absence of catch and the blade is curved and end is fenestrated. So this is ovum forceps, and you know this instrument is sponge holding forceps. This is ovum forceps and this is sponge holding forceps. So this is our next instrument. What is this instrument? Large instrument. This is one of the retractor. This is called diverse retractor. So see the instrument carefully. This is diverse retractor. Next, what is this instrument? This is Doyen's retractor. This is Roentgen's retractor. This instrument is used to retract the urinary bladder during lower segment cesarean section operation. So this is Roentgen's retractor. What is this instrument? This is another type of retractor. This is Landon's bladder retractor. This is Landon's bladder retractor. See this instrument? This is Landon's bladder retractor. So this is Roentgen's retractor and this is Landon's retractor. And this is Divard's. So Divard's retractor, Roentgen's retractor, this, and this is Landon's bladder retractor. So three retractors. This is myoma screw. See this part, screwed part. This is myoma screw. This instrument is used to fix the myoma during myomectomy operation. So this is myoma screw. This is myoma screw. Myoma screw. Next instrument is this. This is cervical punch biopsy forceps. This is cervical punch biopsy forceps. See carefully this terminal end. So this is punch biopsy forceps used to take cervical biopsy sample. So this is cervical punch biopsy forceps. Cervical punch biopsy forceps. This is cervical punch biopsy forceps. This is suction cannula. This is metallic suction cannula. This is metallic suction cannula. See the presence of opening or pore in the lateral part of the stem. This is suction cannula with lateral opening. Metallic suction cannula. This is HSG cannula or hysterosalpingographic cannula. So this is hysterosalpingographic cannula. This hystero used to push dye inside the uterus during hysterosalpingography or HSG examination. So this is metallic suction cannula and this is HSG cannula or hysterosalpingographic cannula. This is ring vaginal pessary. This is ring vaginal pessary used in treatment of prolapse of pelvic organ, uterine prolapse. So this is vaginal ring pessary. Next, what is this instrument? This is bilis mucus sucker. This is bilis mucus sucker used to suck mucus and other material from nose and mouth of the newborn during resuscitation or just after birth. This green end should be in resuscitated mouth and this end should be in baby's mouth or nose. So this is bilis mucus sucker. See the instrument? This is bilis mucus sucker. Next, what is this instrument? See, rubber, made up of rubber. This is simple rubber catheter. This is simple rubber catheter. What is this instrument? This is forceps, as you know from the first year of MBBS. See, there is presence of teeth or tooth. So this is tooth forceps. And another variety is available, that is non-tooth or plain variety. So plain variety will be plain without any tooth. So this is tooth forceps and another variety is available, plain forceps or non-tooth forceps, plain non-tooth. And this is tooth forceps. Used to hold various structures, fiber structures. This is tooth forceps. What is this instrument? As I have told you earlier, this is uterine curette with one blunt end, another sharp end. This is uterine curette, and as I have already compared these two instruments, this is anterior vaginal wall retractor and this is uterine curette. What is this instrument? See this instrument carefully. Very big name. This is olive pointed. See, olive pointed. Olive pointed malleable. See, malleable. This is malleable. Malleable graduated. See, there is presence of marking. Presence of marking. So graduated. Metallic. Made up of metal. Uterine sound. See, graduated. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is graduated. So the full name is olive pointed malleable graduated
metallic uterine sound. Once again, olipointed, graduated, malleable, metallic uterine sound. Next, these are the dilated uterine dilators. Various sizes are available. See the sizes. This is 4 and 5, 3 and 4. This end is 3 and this end is 4 size. See, this is 13, this end is 13 and this end is 12. So 12 and 13. See another 8 and 7. This end is 8 and size is 7. So these are various sizes, uterine dilator or Hegar's dilator. Next, what is this instrument? This is, see, this is IR spatula. This is IR spatula made up of wood and this is endocervical brush. This is IR spatula and this is endocervical brush. Used to take pap smear sample for pap stain. So this is IR spatula and this is endocervical brush. Next, what is this instrument? This is copper T with insert. See, this is copper T. See, T-shaped structure with copper wire around it. This is copper T with inserter and plunger. So this is copper T with inserter and plunger. Intrauterine contraceptive device, IUCD. Next, what is this? Green armillaries forceps. This is green armillaries forceps. So once again, instruments I am showing you another time, one by one. This is Sims double bladed posterior vaginal speculum. Sims double bladed posterior vaginal speculum. This is Casco's bivalve self prepared retaining vaginal speculum. This is anterior vaginal wall retractor. This is multiple tooth valsellum. This is single tooth valsellum. This is sponge holding forceps. These are Alice tissue forceps. This is Babcock forceps. These are hemostatic forceps, artery forceps. This is needle holder. This is needle holder. These are Cocker forceps. See, Cocker's forceps, long and short Cocker's forceps. This is stitch cutting forceps. This is plain scissor and this is episiotomy scissor. This is ovum forceps. This is ovum forceps. This is diverse retractor. This is Doyen's retractor. This is Landon's bladder retractor. This is myoma screw. This is myoma screw. This is cervical punch biopsy forceps. Cervical punch biopsy forceps. This is metallic suction cannula. This is HSG cannula. This is vaginal ring pessary. This is Dilys mucus sucker. This is simple rubber tube. This is tooth forceps. This is uterine curette. This is olive pointed, graduated, malleable, metallic uterine sound. This is the uterine dilator or Hegar's dilator. This is intrauterine contraceptive device, copper T. And this is cervical pap smear sample taking instrument. This is IR spatula and endocervical brush. And what is this instrument? This is our last instrument. This is Scelastic Ventus cup. Scelastic Ventus cup used for ventus delivery. So this part is applied to fetal head and used to give traction. So this is Scelastic Ventus cup. So this is all about instruments in obstetrics and gynecology. So in this video, I have shown you various instruments in obstetrics and gynecology. In another video, I have already uploaded, I have shown you and told you the uses of this instrument, various instruments in obstetrics and gynecology. So see all the videos related to Ox and Gyne uploaded in my channel. So thank you everyone, please subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon. Thank you very much.